Hi, I want to show in our latest chart a little interesting tip, I think, to do with the catch. We know that a lot of us are challenged in how do we get that catch, where do we get that catch, how effective is our catch. And I think there's something reasonably interesting that we can see here, and I'm going to compare two lots of data. This is a lady who I did a Zoom session with during the week, and just want to look at one stroke here and talk about where we can identify the catch and what's going on before and how it's happening and why it's happening. And then I'm going to show one of my swims and show you what a really lousy catch looks like. So this is the stroke path and force chart. Over here is our slider, and we're going to have a look at the side-on view. Now, just to show you, the red is the glide phase, we know that. But this point here at the end of the glide is effectively when the hand stops moving in the forward direction and starts moving backwards. That's where we detect the end of the glide. It's that change of direction of the hand. And what we're looking for is immediately or as soon as possible after the hand starts moving back towards the feet, we're looking to get hold of that catch. And we're going to have a look at it over here and look at where the forces are at play, at what point during the stroke. So as I pull the slider down here to the end of the glide, you can see this is where we are. Now, she's got a hand drag thing going on. She's just dropping her wrist in here and getting a bit of hand drag. Not a huge problem, but it's there. And here, where I'm putting the dotted line, is where we start to get propulsive with that hand. And so you can see there's this very small gap in here, tiny, from, what are we, 17 and a quarter to 73. So it's less than a tenth of a second between getting to the end of the glide and then getting into a position of propulsion. So if I go and scroll this forward about there, it's literally that tiny little gap in there that you see is the delay or the lag between the end of the glide and then starting to become propulsive. It's a great example of a good catch. Now, to my own eternal shame, I am going to show you one of my swims. And if I go to my latest here, and we'll pick out a stroke, and let's scroll down here to the end of my glide, and this is where I should be getting a catch. But look at what's going on here with my delay to get propulsive. So I'm really only hitting it there at, as it says, 20.4. That's about the time at 20.4 seconds. Yet I'm at the end of the glide at 19.6. So there's 3/4 of a second that my hand is moving back towards my feet. So if I scroll this down here to there, my hand has traveled back towards my feet that distance and achieve no propulsion. Naughty boy. And I think it's interesting to look at how or why that this is happening. And I want to concentrate on this little number in here, 1.04 meters a second. That's the speed that my hand is traveling at that point. And you'll see this change as we go through the stroke. So if I come back here and it enters the water at 1.3, and at the end of the glide, it slowed right down to 0.4 meters a second. And then watch this number as I move this through. 0.4, slowing down, 0.3, 0.3, 0.4, 0.4. Now it's getting a little bit faster at 0.5. And then when it starts to kick, look what happens. I start to get propulsive. So what I'm doing is at the end of the glide, I'm just moving the hand slowly, and I've got to concentrate on not only going over that barrel, but then bringing that hand through with acceleration. It's about the increase in speed that's going to drive that propulsion. And you can see here, for this period in here, I'm getting no propulsion from this point to this point, and my hand speed is very, very slow. And then as I keep pulling, then once we get up here to maximum, I'm at over 3 meters a second. So I just wanted to chuck this out there because it's a really interesting little thing you can spot, either as a coach or as a swimmer, to see how do I identify where I have these little increments of improvement, and what do I need to do to be able to take advantage of that opportunity for improvement. And that's what we're seeing here, is the hands moving back towards the feet. It's not generating any propulsion. It's moving too slowly. It's not accelerating. Yet when we pick that up, then it starts to go through. Hope this little bit of info helps. Thanks.